Did you know that New Haven, Connecticut is the birthplace of the hamburger? 120 years ago, in a restaurant called Louie's Lunch. And it's still there today.
What? Wow.
Pants, check. Shirts, check. Socks, check. Underwear, PJs, check, check. Toothbrush, toothpaste, check, check. Oh, hi there. You might be wondering what I'm doing. Well, honestly, I'm getting a little tired, and I'm looking forward to a long overdue and much needed vacation. What's that? Where am I going? Wherever the road takes me. I'm going on a road trip. I'm going to travel the countryside and see the sights. And oh, by the way, I would appreciate it if you would keep this just between me and you. I don't want you know who hearing about it. I just want to go have a relaxing, quiet vacation without hearing.
Pastor Jeff!
Oh no! He's coming! How does he know these things? I gotta hide the suitcase.
Hey, Pastor Jeff, what's going on?
Hi, Ed. How are you today?
Why are you acting so nervous and you're really sweaty?
Sweaty? I'm not sweating and. Nervous? I'm.
What's this?
Not
looks
nervous,
like
a
list of some sort.
No, that's nothing. It's just something I dropped. Don't worry. No, everything's good.
You're acting really weird. Is there something you need to tell me?
No, everything's fine. Everything is really fine.
You're going on a road trip!
What?
And you weren't gonna tell me!
No, I'm not going on a road trip. I'm staying right here. No, that's not true, but... Fine. Yes, I'm going on a road trip. I needed a vacation.
I can't believe you!
I'm sorry. I would have invited you.
Right.
I would have even told you. But honestly... I'm all packed, I'm in a hurry, and I really can't wait for you to pack too.
You don't need to, I'm all set to go.
How did you do that?
Come on, Pastor Jeff, the road's calling our name.
But,
we can take my car.
Your car?
Yeah, by the way, do you have any gas money? I'm kind of on empty.
Look, never mind, you know what? I really don't need a vacation.
Oh, come on, Pastor Jeff, life is a highway, and we're gonna ride it all. Night long!
Turn the radio off. It's kind of loud.
What? I can't hear you. The radio's kind of loud.
Radio off. It's kind of loud.
What? Hold on. I couldn't hear you. The radio was really loud. What were you saying?
Never mind.
Wait. What are you writing there?
My will.
Come on, Pastor Jeff. Seriously, I'm like the safest driver in the world. You don't have nothing to fear. Hey, look, a penny's on the floor. See? It's a sign of good luck. Got nothing to worry about, Pastor Jeff. This is going to be great. Will you stop writing that thing? Seriously, we got a whole teaching series full of all sorts of fun and hijinks. It's going to be great.
I can hardly wait. Hey, Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome back to Vertical Kids Clubhouse, the only clubhouse we can have fun learning about God and His Word on a regular basis. We are so glad you're with us today because guess what? We are starting a brand new series this week. It's called Life is a Highway, right? Life is a highway. And, you know, the truth of the matter is life is like a highway. It really, really is. It's a journey. It's an adventure you take with Jesus each and every day. Now, I'm sure all of you have gone on a road trip with your family. You know, that's where mom and dad and all the kids pile in the car and you go someplace, you go to a destination. And of course, usually your road trip starts at your home, right? And then you go someplace together in the car. I remember when I was a kid, my mom and dad and I, we got in the car and we drove 15 hours to Disney World. That was a long trip, and that was with just me. I can't imagine if I had brothers and sisters, right? But if you're going to go on a trip to Disney World, you start here in Connecticut and you drive all the way to Florida. And when you do that, you go through not one, not two, not three, not five, but eight different states you drive through. And since you know, you've never been really in Georgia before or North Carolina before. Guess what? You need some help to get through those states. You need some help to get from Connecticut to Disney World in the car. What do you need, you ask? You need directions. You need to know the way that you're going to go, and you need to know that you're going the right way to get there. And one of the things that helps you do that is a thing called road signs. You know, when you're on a highway, that's that big 2 to 3 lane road where everybody's going in the same direction. They're going really fast in their cars. When you're on a highway, you don't have a lot of time to think. So if you see that there's an exit coming up that you need to get off the highway on, for about a mile or two ahead, it says, hey, the exit's coming. Hey, it's a mile away. Hey, it's a half a mile. Hey, it's a quarter mile. Hey, get off here, right? There are signs that direct you or tell you that you're going in the right way. And the truth of the matter is, to go any other way would not be good. Well, one of the signs that we have, one of the road signs that we see is this. It's called what? What does that say, boys and girls? That's right, it says one way. And when you see a one-way sign, it means that there is only one way to go down that street. Just like you all cars go in the one direction on a highway. Well, when you go down a street with a one-way sign, it means there's only one way you can go. To go in the other direction or to go in any other direction is not good, it's not right, and it will get you in trouble. And honestly, it will not get you to where you want to go. Well, one of the destinations that a lot of people wonder about and think about when they're thinking about their life and where their life is going is they think about, what is the way to know God? What is the way to get to heaven? And there are unchurched people out there, people who just don't know about God, and they believe that there are many different ways to get to heaven, and there are many different ways to get to know God. Some of them trust and they pray to Buddha. Some of them believe in Muhammad. Some of them believe that you have to be a nice person or do good things. And they all believe that these are the ways, the very different ways that you can know God and will lead you to get to heaven. But did you know that there really is only one way to know God? And there really is only one way to get to heaven? And sadly, a lot of people don't know this. But I want to read to you from the Bible, God's Word, something that Jesus, God's Son, said about how to get to heaven. He said this in John chapter 14, verses 1 and 2, the night before he was about to be arrested and then die on a cross and be killed. He said these words to his closest followers. He said this in John chapter 14, verses 1 and 2. He said, "Don't be troubled. You trust or believe in God, trust and believe in me too. There are many rooms in my Father's home, and I am going to prepare a place for you." There are many rooms in my Father's home, and I'm going to prepare a place for you. Did you hear that? Jesus said that God's home was in heaven, that Jesus was going to leave this earth and go to heaven to be with God, his Father. See, heaven is God's home. And right there, Jesus was inviting his closest followers, and he invites you and me to go there and be with us too. In fact, Jesus is there right now preparing a place for you and preparing a place for me. But in order for us to get there, we would need directions. We would know how to know God. We would know how to get to heaven. It's kind of like if you were to invite me to come over to your house today, you would have to give me directions on what your street address is and where you live and how I could get from where I am to where you are. I would need directions. Well, the same thing is true when it comes to knowing God and getting to heaven. We need to have some directions. We need to know what is the one way that we go, what is the one way that we get there. In fact, one of Jesus' followers that night when he said these words to them in John 14 asked the question. They said, Jesus, we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way? And Jesus in John chapter 14 and verse 6 said this. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one gets to God the Father any other way except through me. Well, Jesus is God's son. So if anybody would know how to get to God and to get back to his home in heaven, it would be Jesus, right? So don't you think we should listen to the one guy who knows the one way to know God and the one way to get to heaven? It's kind of like this water bottle that I have here. You know, if I want to drink from this water bottle, there's only one way I can do it. Sure, I could take a nail and poke a hole in it, but I'm not going to really be able to drink out of the side of it. The only one way to do it is to unscrew the cap, right, and take a drink. That's the only way the water inside this bottle can get inside of me. It's the only way the water inside this bottle can become a part of me. Someone might say to you, oh no, there are many ways to get water out of this bottle. But really, with the cap on, there's only one way, because any other way that you try to do this is going to be a mess and a disaster, and it will be wrong. Well, the same thing is true about Jesus. Jesus said there is only one way to get to God. There is only one way to get to heaven. And that way is by accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. In fact, the Bible says this in Romans chapter 3. It says, all have sinned and fall short of what God has for them. It doesn't mean we're bad people. It just means that we by ourselves can't make it to God. We need help. We need Jesus. Well, how do you fall short, or how do you miss it? You miss God when you sin. Sin literally means to miss the mark. And when you sin, you're doing things your own selfish way rather than the good way that God has planned for you. You see, when you do things God's way, good things happen. But when you do things any other way, it can be a mess and it can end up being a big mistake. The good news is that God loves you so much that he wants you to do things his way. He wants you to know him, and he wants you to get to heaven. In fact, in John chapter 3 and verse 16, it says this, God so loved the world, that's everybody in the past, in the present, and the future. He loved everybody that's ever going to be born, that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him would not be lost or separated from God forever, but would have eternal life or live with God forever. You see, after Jesus was arrested, he was beaten, and then he died on a cross and was buried in the ground, and he came back to life again, and he did all of that to pay for your and my sins, the things that separate us from God. Jesus is the bridge or the crossover that brings us back to God. He makes it so there's only one way to know God. He is the only way. And it's because he's the only one that can pay for your and my sins. He's the only one that can bring us back to God. So when we believe that Jesus Christ died on the cross, was buried in the ground, and came back to life again, guess what? We are now putting ourselves in a place where we're heading on the right track. We're going in the right direction. We're going the one way that we need to go in order to know God. You see, Jesus was born as a baby, which is what we celebrate at Christmas. And he grew up to be a man to tell the good news that God loves you, God cares about you, and God wants to know you. And then one day, freely and willingly, he stretched out his arms on a cross, which looks like a big wooden letter T, and he died. And he was buried in the ground for one day, 2 days, 3 days, and came back to life again. And he did all of that so that you and I could know God, so that you and I could get to heaven. See, Jesus is the one way. He's made the way to know God. And maybe you're sitting out there this morning and you have friends who you go to school with or who live in your neighborhood, or maybe they're your relatives, your cousins or whatever, and they've never heard about heard the good news that Jesus is the only way to know God. Jesus is the only way to heaven. Don't you think it would be great? Don't you think it would be amazing if you could point them in that direction? If you could be that road sign that would say, hey, you know what? This is the way to know God. This is the way to get to heaven, by accepting Jesus into your heart as your personal Lord and Savior. Or maybe you're sitting out there today and you say, you know what, Pastor Jeff? This is the first I'm hearing of this. I'm one of those people that have kind of thought there's many different ways to get to God. I didn't realize that there's only one way to know God, and that's through Jesus. Right now, whether you're that person or if you know somebody, here's the message. It's really simply this. Believe that Jesus is God's Son, who died on a cross and came back to life again for you. Because God loves you, God cares about you, and God wants to know you. And then ask Jesus into your life to be your Lord, the one you'll live for, and the Savior who washes away your sins. When you do that, not only do you get an opportunity to know God, but you become one of God's children. And now you're on the right way, the one way to get to heaven. And that means you can live the rest of your life in joy and peace, knowing that you're good with God and get to know God a little bit more each and every day, so that when you get to heaven, it'll feel like home. You'll be in home, because guess what? You'll have reached your final destination. Just like going to Disney World, you've reached your final destination. You get to spend forever with God, forever with Jesus, in their eternal home called heaven. So remember, this week, our big answer is, the thing we want you to take away and not forget is this. Jesus is the one and only way to know God and to get to heaven. And I can ask him into my life. So guys, as we always say around here, stay safe, be well, know that we love you, but Jesus, he loves you most of all.